Hi, I'm Brandon with Lenovo, and I'm here today to discuss electrostatic discharge. In this video, we're going to be going over three main topics. What is electrostatic discharge? What types of damage it can do to computer components? And common prevention methods. So what is electrostatic discharge? Electrostatic discharge, or ESD, is a sudden flow of static charge from one object with a higher charge to an object with a lower charge. Have you ever rubbed your socks on a carpet and then touched your friend to shock them? Or have you ever been touching a doorknob or car door and received an electrical shock? If you have, then you've experienced ESD. The shock that you felt came from when the current on your body was passed to the other object. In this case, the car door, doorknob, or your friend that you shocked. This same type of discharge can occur when working in an open computer, damaging vital components.
This is your computer.
This is your computer on ESD.
There are two basic types of damage that ESD can cause to electronic components: immediate and latent. Immediate damage is obvious. You can shock a component on the spot, causing it to quit functioning completely. This type of damage is rare, but at least you know that the component has been destroyed and needs to be replaced. Latent damage is a little more subtle. With latent damage, you've only discharged enough electricity into the component to degrade it and not completely destroy it. This type of damage can cause problems with the long-term functionality of a component and decrease its lifespan. So now I'm going to give you a brief overview of the contents of the ESD field kit. So this is the anti-static mat, and it folds out to form an ESD workspace that's portable and can be used anywhere. You use this to ground yourself to the workspace, to ground yourself and the machine you're working on. This next piece is the alligator clip. You're going to use this when you want to ground yourself to the bare metal of a chassis. This piece here is the ESD wrist strap. You're going to use this to ground yourself to the alligator clip or to ground yourself to the ESD mat. The part of the strap that actually grounds you is this metal piece right here, making contact with your skin. So you're going to want to make sure it's tight to your skin at all times. And finally, we have the cable. This connects the wrist strap to the mat and to the alligator clip. The kit you have may differ from the one that I just showed, but the grounding methods for every kit will be the same. If you have a larger mat in your kit, you can use it to ground a server or a desktop or anything that will fit on the mat. The mat and strap are your first line of defense against ESD, but there are a few other considerations to take into account. You can make yourself and the computer have zero potential of ESD by touching bare metal on the inside of the chassis or by touching the power supply case constantly while working inside the computer. Most computer components will come inside of a static protective bag. It's a good idea to leave the components in the bag until the moment you're ready to replace them in the system. You'll generally want to be standing when you're working inside of a computer. Sitting on the floor or sitting in a chair can cause static to build up, increasing the chances of an electrostatic discharge. You'll want to be standing firmly on a hard surface, and the machine that you're operating on should be sitting on the table. You'll want to make sure to disconnect all cables and cords from the back of your system. Power, keyboard, mouse, monitor, peripherals, everything. Everything. Clothing is insulated, so it can maintain a static field separate from your body. You want to avoid wearing clothes that are prone to gather static. You probably already have a good idea of what type of clothes these are, but it's a bad idea to wear wool or some synthetics. It's a good idea to wear short sleeves to minimize the risk of your clothing touching computer components. Did you know that lumberjacks could work on computers too?
Whoa!
In order to prevent ESD and reduce other complications, you'll want to remove any jewelry or accessories before operating on a computer.
What is wrong with you?
This concludes our video on electrostatic discharge. Hopefully you've come away with a good idea of what ESD is, what types of damage it does to electronics, and how to prevent it.